So, Jeff, so tell me how Knoxville was growing up, bro.
Man, small town, as you know. Everybody know everybody, man. It was like, if I'm from this side of the town, I know whoever on the other side of the town, man. It was so small that we only had one grocery store right there in downtown Macon called Tim Food Market. Real simple growing up. Go to school, do your work, play sports.
Yeah.
It was all sports.
Yeah.
What about Starkville, man?
Same thing. Real small area I grew up in called Moon Farm. Don't nobody really know about that.
I never heard of that one.
Country life. Like you said, everybody knew everybody. Every day we went and shot basketball, football.
I'll never forget, it was our 7th or 8th grade year.
Was
going down, and man, you went up. It was 7th or 8th grade. I'm like, there's no way this man.
Yeah.
All 8. I said, they cheating.
I remember
and
that.
You went up and tried to dunk. I believe you almost jumped from the
free throw line.
Yeah, I said, no.
That.
Nah, something ain't right. We need to check his age or whatever it may be, but he don't supposed to be out here playing with us. But
remember a couple of times where I didn't get picked because I was too small, you know what I'm saying? Until I got a little older, they started picking me. You know, I think that's why I'm where I'm at today, just because of that aspect of just competing at an early age. But you know how it is in Mississippi, like, you appreciate where you come from.
Growing up in Macon, Mississippi is basically a small town. You blink too long, you'll miss it.
It can be difficult. Not much to do. Not much positive things for the students to get into.
You had the one grocery store. You had to go 30 minutes to get a pair of shoes.
When Jeffrey first moved here from Louisiana, his family, they stayed in, it was actually a store. It was a place where his mom worked, and that's where they lived during the night.
It's basically what you get when you grow up in a low-income town.
After that, they moved to a townhouse downtown Macon. It was right in the center of town. He doesn't like to hear me say it, but I always called him a crybaby. Somebody would pick on him, and he would run to his brother. Or if somebody say something to him, his sister Ashley, she would always step up and defend him.
He was the baby, so Jeff was a crybaby. If Jeff got his hair braided, he cried. If you looked at Jeff wrong, he cried.
We fought a lot, just like brothers do. Still fight today, but as a kid, it was more so trying to let him know I'm the big brother. Still remember the first day when we started both playing football. Big old tree in our backyard. We put our football helmet on and shoulder pads and ran to the tree as fast as possible.
He played for the Broncos. He came home and he had all his equipment. I can remember him just being so excited about playing football.
It was everything to him. He'd wake up with his football in his hand. I mean, he loves football. From day one, he started playing.
Growing up here in Starkville, it's not a whole lot outside of sports to do. Well, it kept AJ busy with sports, football, basketball, baseball. He loved those sports and, you know, always played at the park and always played wherever he could.
Brown drives the lane, the shot, good!
He played football, but I felt like baseball was his first love, and I always thought that he would play professional sports, but I thought it would be baseball.
He loved baseball. I started him off as a young age, like 2 years old. He was hitting in the house, hitting the baseball in the house. He's still in Pampers, still hitting the baseball.
I can kind of see that he's going to be a great baseball player. Just had to fine tune some mechanics, throwing wise, hitting wise. One of the best outfielders I ever coached.
I think AJ being drafted both as a football player and a baseball player just shows the freakish athlete that he is. He had every bit the MLB draft stock that led him to being drafted. So he could have potentially played professionally had he decided that's what I'm going to focus on.
They told me they were going to draft him. Wanted to know what it was going to take to get him to sign. I just said, I don't know. You got to ask him because he's great in both sports, football and baseball.
Whichever way he went, whichever direction he decided to go, he was going to be successful. He just decided he was going to be a football player.
10th grade, AJ had a little growth spurt. AJ came out for football and we were like, he looked really good in his uniform, but had no idea about how to play the position. And so that's when the work all started in terms of his growth as a football player.
Okay, so you know, every year we play y'all first game of the season.
First game of the season every year.
Everybody looking forward to it. What's my record against y'all? 2-1. Look at this man right here.
My senior year, your senior year.
Y'all cheated, bro.
It was the last game of my high school career playing against Starkville. You know, my goal was to win that game. And that right there set the tone for the rest of the season.
Y'all won state, right?
Yeah, we won state.
How many times you won state?
3.
Yeah, I can't compete with that.
What about that senior game?
I definitely scored. I think it was something like...
Can't miss none, man.
I stepped out of bounds or something. But y'all got it, though. I think I had a crazy night, though. I think I had like 18 catches.
You did?
For like 2 TDs. Like,
you don't remember my stats?
It don't matter the stats. It don't even matter.
I had 17 tackles, 5 sacks. You know? Block field goal.
You bigger than everybody.
Oh, man.
Oh, boy. Oh, man. Hey.
Oh, man.
I remember it. What? Look at you. Yo, you had the dread, yo.
My 10th grade here.
You bring back some memories right here. You just talking to me in one arm. You won the state championship.
Look, the DB is 5 feet trying to hold you, man. Like, okay. All
right. No, I'm probably scoring about 2-3 touchdowns a game, so.
How many you score against us?
What year?
How big a role is high school football in Mississippi? I don't have a vocabulary big enough to describe how big it is.
I always try to describe it, but my typical answer is you actually have to be there on a Friday night to experience it.
Friday night, if you want to rob the bank, it'd be a good time because everybody's here. I've been coaching 39 years and all of them in Mississippi, except I had one in Georgia and 2 in Tennessee. So I'd been out. And I was supposed to interview for the job the next week, and they were playing a spring game against South Panola. And my wife and I rode down just to watch it because I wanted to see the talent level. There was a guy at number 15 lined up out there, and after he run one route and caught the ball and took off, I told my wife, that that's what a football player really looks like. That's my first time I recognized A.J. Brown.
He was better than I thought he was going to be. I just thought we were going to send him down so he'd get the aspect of playing. He turned out to be a great wideout. Kind of knew from that point on he was going to be a football player.
You know, AJ got triple teamed a lot. We always got double teams. You know, I know one thing. If you get a ball close to him, he's going to catch it. You know, he just didn't drop anything.
We just won a state championship. That's awesome.
In my area, Starkville, Columbus, Macon, West Point, that entire Golden Triangle area, which is what it was called, the first two names you heard about were A.J. Brown and Jeffrey Simmons.
Jeffrey's older brother, Dylan Bradley, was a standout player for the Tigers in Noxubee County as well. I remember going to a game that I was covering for Starkville High School at Noxubee. And I remember talking about what a great player Dylan Bradley was. And somebody in the radio booth, or actually in the press box, said, "He's a nice player, wait till you meet his brother." And he pointed to a guy right outside the press box standing on the steps. He said, "That's Jeffrey Simmons. You're gonna wanna write that name down."
When he was 9th grade, You know, we moved him to the varsity football team, and I can remember one day at practice, he was going against some seniors and some juniors, and he was getting his butt whooped. Every time he get whooped, that kid would come right back, tears running down his eyes. And I used to say, ain't no crying in football. And he used to get right back in it, right back up. And I knew then, when he was ninth grade, I said, this kid gonna be special.
AJ and Jeffrey played against each other. Usually it was the first game of the season. That was always the biggest game on our calendar.
And Starkville lost one game all year long. Who was it to? Noxubee County. Noxubee County lost one game all year long. Who was it to? Starkville.
Especially senior year, it grew into an AJ Jeffrey kind of game because you had these two 4- or 5-star talents that were going to play in the SEC that I think all of us knew were going to play in the NFL. 1, 2, 3.
Starkville beats Noxubee County bad. It was a pretty good beatdown for AJ and company. AJ had a monster game. But Jeffrey told a lot of people that he would never forget that game. Now you fast forward a year, we're in Noxubee County. Jeffrey Simmons ended that game with 17 tackles, 5 sacks, 3 tackles for a loss, he blocked a field goal, and he recovered a fumble. And Noxubee County beat Starkville in double overtime. That was the first time you really saw Jeffrey and AJ man on man in a game.
Noxubee is an ultra-competitive program, and Jeffrey was right at the forefront of that. On the other end, you had Starkville High School, which was also built on some of those same things, and AJ Brown was at the forefront of that. Jeffrey was a national recruit. He was a 5-star. He was one of the top defensive linemen in the country.
When it was time for him to pick his school, I remember this conversation. The young, light-voiced nephew on the phone, and he said, Unc, I don't know what to do. You know, all types of colleges coming at me. You know, people want me to go here. People want me to go there. And I just told him, I say, you the one got to put your hand in the dirt. You the one got to wake up and go to class every day. What feels right for Jeff?
I feel like I have a great opportunity at Mississippi State, especially going in, just got to learn the defense. I think I got a great chance of playing.
My hat's off to him just being a young man in that situation where a lot of people could have steered him, but he stood up and was his own man and made his own decision, and I'm very proud of him for that.
On signing day, it was crazy. It was standing room only, just waiting in anticipation. Where's AJ going? Where's he going?
I started covering AJ Brown his junior year of high school because there were some rumors out there that he didn't want to go to Mississippi State, that he wanted to get out of Starkville and explore other places. There was no way, right? There's no way that AJ Brown is going to hold a press conference at Starkville High School, the home of Mississippi State Starkville, and announce in front of God and everybody that he's going to Ole Miss. And the minute he said the University of Mississippi, the place exploded.
But the next 3-4 years, I'll be taking my time to the University of Mississippi. Yeah!
I understand that rivalries are a big deal in college football, and everybody points to Alabama and Auburn and any number of other rivalries, but you'd be hard-pressed to find one where there's as much bad blood as Ole Miss and Mississippi State.
It was extremely hard. Me picking Ole Miss, not living in Starkville, I know I'm gonna hear about that one for a long time, but I just had to go with my heart.
You knew for the next 3 years, a big piece of this rivalry was gonna be Jeff Simmons and AJ Brown squaring off just like they'd done so many times on these high school fields under a little bit, you know, lights that wasn't quite as bright. Well, the lights were all kinds of bright now, and you knew that you were about to have 3 years of showdowns, and that's what we got.
Them
two team in Mississippi took that game serious. Like,
yeah.
When we got ready to play Alabama, it was okay. Let's beat Alabama.
Yeah.
When we got to play Ole Miss, yeah. Let's beat the hell out of Ole Miss. You know, yeah, it was yeah, like yeah, one of them yeah. games. Keep your trophy here in Mississippi State, and that's how it was.
What a trophy at now?
I mean,
okay.
I know what it was when I was there, but we're going to get it back. It's all good.
I'm just
saying. It's all good.